Hey, here we are, day five, and it is 3:15 in the morning. Let's see, I'm a little hungry, a little thirsty. So again, this series is just a learning series, so I can learn how to play this game. I promise you, if you're looking for someone who is like super duper incredibly good at games, y'all, I ain't the one. But I am gonna have fun with it. And let's see, I did figure out how to get food. I don't know if it's the right way. I killed a wolf and got some food off him or her. And I finally figured out how to get water. So it looks like I'm thirsty. Let's see, drink until enough. So let's look at drink until enough. I don't know if that means drink until you're not thirsty. See, it didn't fill me all the way up. So I want to be filled all the way up. But right now I have no water. It says 100%, but yeah, there's nothing in there. That kind of is baffling to me a little bit. So I got this little water thingy right here. And I don't like the placement of all this stuff, but you know what? I'm going to figure it out eventually, get it right, get it just in the right place and all that, and we will be good. So we're going to fill this back up with water, and we're going to drink some more because I want my little dude to be in tip-top shape. All right, drink until enough. Oh, yeah, that's good stuff. Now, more better. Okay, so I got a couple more pieces of meat on me. So two more pieces. I don't know how long this lasts, and I don't know if it rots or not like it does in other games, so we'll find out. But guess what? We got some, y'all. And we got this gun down here that I accidentally killed a tree with. So I'm going to take it and put it up somewhere. If I can figure out where I'm at. Where in the world am I at? That door is in my way. Okay, I got around that door. I'm going to put it in here because I don't have any ammunition in it. And I brought my workbench around here too. And it needs a couple gears to upgrade. And I don't know if I have any gears. I don't think I have gears, but I'm going to look to see if I do. If not, I think we might try to find some gears to do some upgrades. No gears. And I think I've just left the gears because I didn't know what to do with them. So, they say equipment. I have gloves on. These are garden gloves. Tactical gloves I think are better. Let's put some tactical gloves on. Yeah, that's more better. And let's see, I need to store these gloves somewhere. I can store them in this red cabinet over here. That's what I'm going to do. Put them in the red cabinet for now. All right, and anything else I can do? Crowbar. I don't know what to do to crowbar, but I got that sucker, so I'm happy about that. We can get into stuff. Yeah. Those doggies are out there like crazy talking to me and stuff. There's more than one of them. Let's go ahead and make a stick. And then we'll store the sticks somewhere. I don't know where the sticks are now, but oh, no. I don't want you on. Take you off. I wanted to press the E button. My button mashing skills are pretty darn bad. Will it stack more than 16? Yes, it will not. Yes, it will not. All right. So it's still dark. And I don't know if I can get out right now, because I thought the zombies come out at dark, but maybe they just come out during mist. So I don't know if it's a good idea to go out in the world or not. So I think I'm just going to rest for maybe another hour until the light comes up a little bit more, just to be safe. All right, y'all, it is almost 8 o'clock in the morning, and I've rested a couple times to kind of make time pass, and it's still kind of misty, or I'm saying misty, but it could be just foggy out. I don't know if this is a good thing or a bad thing. I haven't heard any zombies walking around or anything like that. I did take the opportunity. I ate some more. I drank some more. I ate some more. So we're going to have to eat constantly, it looks like. Man, when you rest, your dehydration and your hunger just go down like crazy. So what we're going to do is look at something else, maybe. Yeah. Now, I did make me a quiver, so I found out in the crafting bench that if I used 8 cloth, I could make a quiver. So I have a quiver. I don't have my bow on me or anything like that yet, but I did make that and put it in its slot. I noticed that the workbench needs gears to upgrade, so I want to see if I can find... I know I've seen one. See if I can find the gears. Upgrade that, and we're just gonna roam around for a little bit today. We'll start here. I don't think there was... Okay, so there's a crash somewhere. There's the crash. So I was gonna say, I know I can use my pencil to see where the crash happened at, but I didn't have to because I see where this sucker happened at. Okay, let's just walk. I wonder if I can just trade the dude some rocks for something. Will you take rocks, dude? Will you take rocks? Most likely not, but... And he might not want to trade. I don't know if that happens every single time. I assumed it did. Let's see. Rescue the dude. Proceed. Hello? You're most welcome. I'm glad I could help you out. Thanks. What are you giving me? Add to inventory. Trade? You have anything? A shirt. Do I have a shirt? I don't know if I have a shirt or not. What is that right there? I don't know what that is. What is that? I have no idea what that is. So I'm going to keep it. This is my hat. My quiver, my gloves, my jeans, medicine. Yeah, I don't think we're going to trade. I don't think we're going to trade. I really, yeah, we're not, dude. Sorry. Good luck. Have a great one. All right, let's look in this. We will take his stuff. I'm glad he had some stuff. Alright, so I found out that you don't have to open the door to enter. You can just press the F key to enter. So that was a good time saver. I so appreciate that. Awesome, Blossom. And then F to get back out. So that's pretty cool. You don't have to open the door. You can just press F to enter the car. I guess it helps if you look at things and read them sometimes. But I'm not that good at that. I don't have a lot of attention to detail skills. So I know we've been here several times, and I don't think loot re-loots or respawns. Blueberries. I like blueberries, y'all. Ain't nothing in there but a pile of... Never mind, can't say that on TV. There used to be this show that says you can't say that on TV. I never watched it, but I always like to say, and you can't say that on TV. And I know we're not on TV. Or maybe we are on TV. I don't know. Okay. Was there something in here that I didn't get? There's a gear somewhere. I'm thinking it was most likely in the barn, but just to... I can take the firewood. How much weight did that add? Ooh, that put me at almost 50% weight. And current location. Okay, so I'm right here close to the sawmill, I guess. Okay, so I've never been here, so we are here at the sawmill. And let's just see what we can find here. I've just been roaming around. Oh, heck. Heck, hey, dude. Why you do that? Where'd you come from? Oh my gosh, why would you do something like that? That's just wrong. All right, so let's butcher that sucker. Butcher. We're gonna butcher. We're gonna take your meat. It's gonna take time. It's okay. We got time, I think. But I can't do it with that. I can do it with that. It takes 2 hours with that. 45 minutes with that. Let's do it. Proceed. Okay. So we're at the sawmill, and it is 3 o'clock, so time is flying by, y'all. And I've never been at the sawmill before, so I'm probably going to have to come back here a few times to look around. Sawmill. And don't appear to be a whole lot of stuff here at the sawmill. Nothing here. Boxes floating in the air and nothing here. Well, the sawmill's not looking very promising at all, y'all. Hey, there's a board. Haha, we picked up a board. We got a board at the sawmill. And I'm sure there's, like I said, I'm going to have to come back multiple times probably just to search it out, make sure I don't miss anything. Nothing in here. I like how they went through the detail of putting fans in the top of the walls. Like they've been in a sawmill before or a manufacturing facility before. Rags. Wood. Wood is good. Wood is good at the sawmill. Yeah, not a whole lot here. Another piece of wood. Scrap metal. Whoops, can't pick that up. Alright. So these are components. Okay, components. So there is more scrap metal here. What is that? Lashing, okay. So I can come back here and get some more scrap metal stuffy that I can't tote right now. Let's get this floating rag. Oh, we can't get the floating rag. We're full. Alright, so I think we're going to go back home now and dump stuff off. And now I know where this place is. I'll come back here later and check it out again. But I have officially been to the sawmill on day 5. Yay! Alright, I'm starting to learn how the roads are connected a little bit. So I come down this little dirt road right here from the sawmill. And here's this old gas station right here that I've been at before. So I know if I go back up this road that there is the barn on the right hand side that I went to earlier. And then past the barn is the little dirt road on the left that goes back to what I'm calling my base right now. So we're going to go back up to that. And hey, you know what? It is 3:44, so yeah, I'm learning a little bit, y'all. I got some more meat to cook. That's good. And I know there's a few more things at the sawmill that I need to get. Now, one thing that really baffled me a little bit was that wolf got me when I first got to the sawmill, and I didn't even hear it or know it was around me, so that was kind of weird that it would do that. But hey, it's a learning thing in the game, and I'm going to learn the things in the game. Stamina is starting to drop down quite a bit. So I've yet to go down this road right here. We're going to do that. We won't do it this episode. I can't pick up anything. And I can't really get rid of anything, I don't guess. So that is probably going to be the next thing, is go down that road right there. Just to see where it goes. And yeah, I think, I'm learning stuff. Yes, I am. I figured out that I can whack the wolves with my machete and kill them. And I found out where the sawmill was, so I'm happy about that. And we'll just see how things go. But I think we're just going to get back to our little base and drop some stuff off and cook some more meat, because we got to have the meat and go from there. So I probably won't do anything else for this episode. But y'all, day 5 is going to be over with. We'll call it here. And I'm learning stuff. I'm learning my way around the map just a little bit at a time. And hey, if you got any insight on the wolf, on why it just suddenly attacked me and I didn't know it was behind me, so I didn't hear it growl or anything, or maybe I just missed it, let me know. And the sawmill seemed to be really disappointing to me. There was a big area on the map, it looked like, but nothing there at all. It was just blah. I mean, there's a few more pieces of scrap metal that I can go get, and I know it's there, but really nothing there, nothing that I found. And I didn't spend a whole lot of time looking. I did spend a lot of time carving up a wolf, so maybe I should spend more time looking. But anyway, give me your thoughts on the sawmill. I would appreciate it, y'all. Thanks for hanging out with me. Y'all have a great one. See you next time.